A new event is just around the corner with new rewards, new challenges, and unvaulted weapons. This event is going to be crazy. Be sure to watch until the end. All right, guys, welcome back to another Fortnite video. And in this one, as I already said, we have a ton of stuff to cover. Like the rewards, I'm going to be showing you a bunch of the rewards that you can unlock from this event. And there's like some super cool ones. So I'll be showing you those. We'll also be going over like the overview of this event. Again, how there's going to be like unvaulted items and weapons and stuff like that, as well as a bunch of other things like some changes in today's update, some important ones, and just keeping you guys up to date on all of this stuff. So if you do enjoy it, be sure to hit that like button down below, as well as comment which skin is better. All right, I'm curious to see, is it Demi or Stratus? Comment your favorite down below and let's see which one gets more comments. But yeah, guys, without further ado, let's jump on into it. And oh yeah, guys, if you want to help support me, you can do so by using code TheLlamaSir in the item shop. So if you appreciate this update news, consider doing that. But yeah, guys, let's go ahead and jump into it. First of all, with like an overview of what this event is and like when we can expect to see it in the game. So basically, this event is called the 14 Days of Summer event. And by the way, guys, just throwing it out there, I predicted that this event was going to happen 4 weeks ago. So I mean, come on, guys, if you're not subscribed, what are you doing? Like, our ideas and stuff are on point. So basically, yeah, it's called 14 Days of Summer, and basically it's a summer event. You've got a lot of summer themed items, summer themed challenges and things like that, but that's not the only thing about it. Apparently there's going to be like beach parties. I'm not exactly sure what that means quite yet. We heard from like Lucas7Yoshi on Twitter that there's probably like beach parties, and just overall a ton of beach and summer themed things are going to be happening. So it's going to be a ton of fun. On top of that, when is the release date of this? Well, we don't know 100% quite yet, but considering that these challenges are already in the game and the rewards are already in the game, it's bound to be happening super duper soon. And taking a look at the in-game stuff itself, you can see that they're for the current challenges, it is the Horde Rush LTM. So we got at least 20 hours as I'm making this video. So it could be happening as early as tomorrow. And if it's already in the game and you want to see the rewards and stuff, keep on watching this video. But if it's not in the game, yeah, I'm expecting it to come out in like maybe the next week or so. That would be my estimated guess. But until we get an official message from Fortnite, you know, it's kind of up in the air. But yeah, guys, let's go ahead, keep it going here, and jump into some of the rewards you can get from the challenges. Since this is a full-fledged event, 14 days of summer, I believe we're going to be getting a challenge every single day for those 14 days, and that means a bunch of rewards. And like each day you get a really cool reward. It's not like XP. And also, guys, be sure to subscribe if you haven't yet, because I'm planning on posting some guides for the challenges. All right, guys, so starting it out with the first item, this is probably one of the best because it is literally the Peely inside of the blender as a backbling. That is right, guys. And also credit to both Lucas7Yoshi on Twitter and also fnbr.co for these pictures and images. But yeah, guys, as you can see here, this is the Peely banana thing backbling. what is the official name for it? I believe it is called Smoothie. It's simply Smoothie, and it is a rare backbling. So yeah, this one's pretty cool. Definitely one of my favorites. I love the look of the Peely on it, and I'm assuming it's animated similar to how in the trailer, you know, you had Peely's face react when he was in the blender. That's definitely really cool. Keeping it going here though, with the next one, you have an emote that is called Deep End, which I'm not really sure what it's going to look like, but as you can see right there, there is the image. So maybe you guys know if you do know what it's based off of, or maybe it's just original. The description for it apparently says dive in, but I'm not really sure what that means. It's maybe like that one dance, I can't remember, like where you like sort of snorkel and like go underwater, you act like you're going underwater. You guys probably have no idea what I'm talking about, but that's okay. So yeah, new emote, definitely pretty cool. After that, you then have a loading screen, which, you know, loading screens are always kind of interesting, nothing crazy, but there you can see the loading screen right there. And you can also see a bunch of other skins that are likely going to be coming into the item shop. Maybe we'll talk a little bit about those later on in the video, not 100% sure yet. But yeah, that is a loading screen. And also, I believe these items and stuff are in order of the challenges, not 100% sure, but something to keep in mind. After that, you then have a throwable item slash toy, which is the water balloon. And this, you know, this is gonna be fun. A water balloon type item, probably going to be very similar to the other throwable type items, like for example the snowball. Just imagine that, but instead you're throwing a water balloon, and when it hits somebody, it's probably going to splash with like water and stuff like that. But as for a little water balloon, it's definitely pretty interesting. Keeping it going here though, then with the next reward, I don't have a picture of these next two, unfortunately, but basically this next one is imagine Peely as an emoticon. I think that's what they're called, the little throwable emotes and stuff that you can get in game. So nothing crazy. I know you guys probably aren't aren't too interested in that type of item, but again, it's a peely emoticon, basically, or sorry, peely smoothie emoticon. So yeah, just imagine that. That's basically what it is. And then after that, you also have a spray, which is basically like a sort of painted sun with Peely's face on it. So again, nothing too crazy. It is a spray, an item that not a ton of people use, but you know, a free item nonetheless. So, you know, I'll take it. But after that, then you have the, you have a special wrap, which it is called Neon Tropics. And as you can see right here, it is a pretty bright wrap. Got a lot of pink, a lot of teal, or not teal. I'm forgetting the name of that color. Also yellow. And then the secondary color is like a, you know, pretty normal blue. Doesn't look to be anything animated or reactive or something like that. So I'm not expecting it to be. You never know. It could be. They could throw a curveball and it could be reactive or something. But as of right now, it just looks like a normal wrap. Pretty solid wrap overall. So, you know, I'm happy with that. Keeping it going here again, though, we've still got a bunch of items to go through. After that, you then have another loading screen, which again showcases the water balloon item on it. But as you can see, pretty cool right there. Nice little loading screen. Also, oddly enough, you can see that that skin right there is, yeah, that is a drift skin that is apparently going to be in the item shop, according to various people. Yeah, it is going to be in the item shop. I know a lot of people were talking about how that's kind of weird because obviously Drift is a battle pass skin. So having a variant of him in the item shop, and I mean, you can see from this, it's a summer variant. He's got the same gloves, hair, mask, stuff like that. At least I think it's the same gloves, but you know, that is a bit interesting. I'm not sure what I think about that yet myself. Maybe the OG Drift owners will get something special because of it, like when they've done stuff similar to this in the past. Like when they re-released Skull Trooper, the OG Skull Trooper owners got a special variant. So hopefully they do decide to do something like that, but I'm not 100% sure yet. But yeah, guys, sorry, got a little bit off track there, but hey, it's a pretty interesting topic to talk about nonetheless. After that then, though, you have a item that we're not sure about. This was like the only one that was not revealed. It just shows up as a question mark, according to Lucas7Yoshi. But yeah, that's a little bit odd. So we'll have to wait and see what this like secret type item is. After that, there's also another spray, which I'm not really sure what it is. It looks like a surfing type spray, but I wasn't able to get a good picture of it. So sorry about that, but yeah, it's a new spray. After that, then you have a new double pickaxe, which is the low and slow, which is pretty cool. I like the looks of these. And again, it's a free item. That's always a ton of fun. Probably very similar to the fork knife. So imagine the fork knife, but as these right here. And that is another rare item. And again, obviously double pickaxes. So you're swinging them, holding them in both hands. Gotta love it. And it's also like grill type utensils instead of the fork knife. You got the spatula and the little pokey thing. I'm not sure what it's called. Keeping it going here. Once again, you have a contrail, which is like the beach balls contrail, I believe it's called. Something along those lines. But basically, as you can see, it's probably going to be like, you know, throwing a bunch of beach balls after you when you're diving on down. So it looks like a ton of fun. I don't use a ton of contrails personally, but you know, if you're into contrails and you want to come up with like a summer themed skin combo, that's what you're going to want to use. On top of that, you've also got a quack pack, I believe it's called, which is a back bling that is basically a rubber ducky. Yeah, this is a back bling. I thought maybe it was a throwable toy or something like that, but it is indeed a back bling. So, you know, pretty interesting right there. I think that's actually, remember when we had to find a bunch of those on the map? It might be the same exact one. So that's pretty interesting right there. I don't believe you have to find any duckies, but I could be wrong. But yeah, pretty cool. On top of that, you also have two more items here. You have the Sparkles music pack. That is right, guys, a music pack in the challenges. That is really cool. And I think Sparkles, oh, what emote is that? I can't quite remember, but I think it's like True Hearts, maybe. I'm not 100% sure, obviously, as of right now. It's simply called Sparkles. I don't believe we have an emote called Sparkles, but it kind of reminds me of True Hearts. So, I mean, that's what I would guess. But pretty cool to see a music pack as a reward. And then for the final item, it's simply a banner, probably because, you know, it's the last challenge. So, you know, you're going to have less time to complete it. So adding something not super crazy. And then the banner, again, sorry, I don't have a good picture of it, so I can't really show it to you. It's basically just a grill as a banner. I'm sure you guys aren't that interested in it. But yeah, guys, those are some crazy items. What do you think about them? Leave your comments down below. But I think they're pretty cool. But moving on here to more stuff about this event, and then we'll have one final thing to talk about after that. But basically, that is the fact that it seems to be like every single day of this event, we'll be getting a different item on Vaulted. That is right, guys. According to Lucas7Yoshi, she. That's what's going to be happening. Each day we're going to be getting a daily unvaulted weapon, which could mean that maybe they add up and like over time they're going to get all 14 unvaulted weapons at the same time. But instead it's probably going to be that each day there's going to be a new unvaulted weapon and then it's going to switch out to a different one, so it's just one a day. But either way, that's really exciting because 14 different days of these, 14 different unvaulted weapons to try out in game. That's going to be a lot of fun. I'm curious to see how that's going to work out and which ones are exactly going to get unvaulted. Which ones do you guys want to see unvaulted? Leave a comment down below. I'm curious to see what you guys have to say about that. For me personally, the Zappotron. I mean, come on, we gotta have the Zappotron. It's totally possible though. That's the cool thing about it. And then final thing real quick I wanted to talk about in this video. This was just one super big thing about the patch today, and basically a bunch of vaulted weapons. You've got the Boombo vaulted, which is crazy. It's not the only item, but it's probably the biggest. Personally, I liked using the Boombo, but didn't like having other people use it against me. So, I mean, it makes sense. It was a very powerful item. So, yeah. On top of that, you also have dual pistols, which got vaulted. That's a bit surprising. I didn't really expect to see that. They're fairly balanced, but I guess with, like, all the new changes to items, I mean, it kind of makes sense. I'm not 100% sure, though. And then, finally, you also have the dynamite, which got vaulted, and apparently a bunch of these explosives are due to there being, like, a lot of them. So, yeah, guys, pretty interesting overall, but that is going to be it for today's video. If you did enjoy it, be sure to hit that subscribe button down below for more fun videos like this in the near future. On top of that, be sure to check out some of my previous videos here, such as on the left, going over some important things with a new game mode in like the monster, and then on the right, the Stranger Things event. But other than that, guys, hope you enjoyed today's video, and I will see you in the next one.